What's the tea? 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 What's the tea?
Hello, hello, everyone. I am the Water Bear, and welcome to the Water Bear's Tea. This is the weekly energy reading from March the 1st through the 7th, and I'm entitling this week. Category is Brainwash, okay? And no, we're not going to get brainwashed this week, but every alignment this week is about re-innovating your mind, thinking, communicating, using the brain, okay? And so that's where the title came from. And so just stay tuned for me to get deep into that, because this week is very powerful. There are not too many alignments this week, but there will be a noticeable shift in the collective by the end of this week, okay? How's everybody doing from this recent full moon we had in Virgo? This is a very, very powerful full moon that we're still in the energy of, and we'll be feeling for the next 2 weeks, okay? Super, super powerful. It just wrapped up a 5-month journey of full moons, and it's starting a 6-month journey of full moons. And if you remember, you know more about that, you checked out the full moon message, where I talked all about the importance of this full moon. And so I really am excited for what's to come, because it's definitely gonna be very externalized, if that makes sense, okay? And so this week, we're having a lot of, again, like I said before, mental focus. Again, look at this daggone cough. And recently I've been so like connected to like the metaphysical meanings of the body. And in a lot of readings, I've been feeling whatever kind of is going on, okay, in my physical body, all right? Perks of being a Virgo rising, okay? And anytime I get like a cough that's like down here, it's like weird, and it comes randomly, it has something to do with communication and the throat chakra and maybe someone watching. And then there's the cough, so there's a confirmation. Someone watching maybe is nervous to put themselves out there, or nervous to express themselves authentically, or bring up something, or speak the truth, or take actions off of the truth or what they're thinking. Like it could be that what you're processing and thinking is getting stuck, you know, in your throat chakra. What you want to express, you've been planning it, but actually vocalizing it, sharing it is the issue, okay? But it's something with communication, okay? And so this week, get ready if this is the person that, if you are the person that I'm feeling, because, or the people, that could be the whole general collective. We're all, there's something we want to express or get out or share that we're a little bit nervous of, or there's something that we put out recently that we're nervous of how it's going to affect us or something like that, okay? Because this week is all about mental focus, mental shifting, communication, and all a lot with the throat chakra, okay? And so, you know, it's going to be very powerful. The next thing I wrote down, the full moon is bringing in some grounding energy currently, okay, which is very true. The past few days it has been a lot more chilled, a lot more mellowed in the energy, more stable, I would say. Definitely more emotional and really looking into, you could be focusing more on the past as well, or just more, just chill, okay? Because that full moon in Virgo occurred, Venus and the Sun are now in Pisces, which is adding a little bit more water, which is diluting all of the heavy air energy we were feeling in January and February, okay, which is mainly mentally active energy. But to let you know, after the middle of this week, that energy is going to pick back up, and we still have a touch of energy in you know, Pisces, that watery energy. And a little bit of the Virgo energy holding us for this week and a little bit of the next week. But the main thing we're going to have is Mars moving into Gemini. Excuse me. And Mars is what we're doing in our divine masculine energy. And it's been chilling in Taurus since the start of January. Okay. And that has been really keeping the lid on all the air energy. So it's made us like really mentally frustrated because we're thinking and planning all these things. But there's been this energy of like, I haven't had the energy to put it out there, or there's been lots of patience tests and roadblocks, and you know, it hasn't been matched up, okay? And now, once Mars moves into Gemini this week, Gemini's energy is very well matched up. It's the sister sign of Aquarius, okay, which is where all the mental energy is still. So there's going to be this really nice link up, which is going to allow an outlet, Mars, for all of our mental energy. Okay, and so enjoy this little bit of grounding energy, because on the 3rd of March, Mars moves into Gemini, right? So yeah, okay. So I'm going to do a little bit of announcements real quick, and then we're going to jump into the charts to go deeper into this. Then I'm going to end with an oracle card.